Hi everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going over the origin, the insertion and the action of the flexor pollicis longus muscle.
The flexor pollicis longus is a deep flexor muscle in the anterior of the forearm. You can see it highlighted here in green. Some other muscles close by to the flexor pollicis longus are the brachioradialis, the flexor carpi radialis, and the flexor digitorum superficialis. The flexor pollicis longus is a deep muscle of the forearm, so all three of those muscles I've just showed you, they're going to be superficial to the flexor pollicis longus, meaning they're closer to the skin surface. Here we can see the flexor pollicis longus muscle in isolation. You can see how it's connecting onto the radius here, which is next to the ulna. The flexor pollicis longus then comes down here, crosses over the wrist joint and connects onto the tip of the thumb. Let's go over the origin and insertion in more detail. So you can see now I've highlighted the first origin point here in red, and that's going to be on the anterior surface of the radius. Our next origin point is going to be the interosseous membrane, which you can see I've just brought into view here. The interosseous membrane is a fibrous sheet of connective tissue that connects the radius here to the ulna. And that interosseous membrane is going to be another origin point for the flexor pollicis longus muscle. So next you can see the insertion marked out here in blue, and that's going to be on the base of the distal phalanx of the thumb. So this bone would be the distal phalanx, this would be the proximal phalanx, and then this would be the metacarpal of the thumb.
So let's take a look at the actions next. Now the primary action of the flexor pollicis longus muscle is going to be flexion of the thumb. Let's take a closer look at that.
Here we can see flexion of the interphalangeal joint. This is where the proximal phalanx meets the distal phalanx. So you can see on the left here, I've labelled the IP joint on my own thumb, and that's the interphalangeal joint. On the right hand side you can see this diagram where I've got all of the bones of the thumb colour coordinated to their names. I've also labelled the joints there. Feel free to pause the video if you want to take a closer look at that. Next, you can see I've started flexing the metacarpophalangeal joint portion of the thumb, as well as the interphalangeal joint as well. The MCP joint is labelled on my own hand here. MCP stands for metacarpophalangeal. Because the flexor pollicis longus also crosses the wrist joint, it can also provide weak assistance during flexion of the wrist. However, its primary action is going to be flexion of the thumb.
See if you've enjoyed the video or you find it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press that like, subscribe, let me know what you thought of the video in a comment. It really helps out the channel. Thanks again for watching everyone. See you all next time.